Well, fresh off the plane from his diplomatic mission to Washington, Anthony Albanese is about to do it all again, heading to China later in the week. Let's bring in Meera Rapp Hooper, Special Assistant to the President and Senior Director for East Asia and Oceania at the National Security Council in the White House. She joins us inside the White House right now. Meera, thank you so much for your time. Look, there's so much going on in the Middle East right now. How concerned is the White House about a wider conflict?
It's great to see you, Carl. There certainly is quite a lot going on in the Middle East right now, and our leadership is fully devoted to managing that crisis and conflict. There are certainly concerns about a wider conflict, but we, just like our friends in Australia, are devoted to doing the work of diplomacy all day, every day, to try our best to manage it.
Okay, Benjamin Netanyahu this morning was resolute. The war will continue. I guess that balance of being able to support Israel while it's doing that is a tough balance for not just the US, but all allies.
It is a balancing act, to be certain, but one of the many things that our leadership here in Washington is very good at, Carl, is being able to manage the crisis of the day while also staying focused on our long-term interests and objectives. And that's exactly what President Biden did when Prime Minister Anthony Albanese visited him here at the White House just last week. They certainly touched on the crisis taking place in the Middle East and talked about what they could do to support the path back to peace. They also talked about their continuing support and assistance to Ukraine. But so much of their discussions was laser focused on our long-term interests in the Indo-Pacific, whether that was in the Pacific Islands or in Southeast Asia, and all the cooperation that we are working on together to make sure that that region stays free and open. So while the crisis of the moment is never far from hand, so too did these leaders spend a lot of time focused on that long-term work.
The president seemed to indicate that we shouldn't go in softly with Beijing. It's going to be a little bit different for our prime minister. I can't see him going in and shirt-fronting Xi Jinping. What is the message there that the US wants delivered, and how delicate is that balance for our prime minister?
Well, of course, the prime minister will deliver his own message. He's thought a lot about his own diplomacy in Beijing. He and his team are well prepared. The prime minister and the president did have the opportunity to exchange thoughts, and they are in agreement that responsible diplomacy with Beijing is an appropriate thing to do. From a U.S. perspective, we are certainly in a competition with China, but managing that competition means engaging in serious, thoughtful, and responsible diplomacy. So like Prime Minister Albanese, we've seen a number of different world leaders engage with Xi Jinping over the course of the last many months. You've seen several American cabinet secretaries travel to China to have serious discussions in their issue area. And again, that is part of managing a set of challenges that will be with us for some number of years.
Does the U.S. government trust the Chinese?
I don't think that diplomacy necessarily requires trust. The basis for diplomacy is a simple acknowledgement of some amount of shared interest and shared desire to work forward together. So I'll leave that one to decide.
I love how honest you are. Diplomacy doesn't require trust. We really appreciate you being on. Love to talk to you again very soon. Thanks for being on our show here in Australia. Ta.